Most of you are facing this problem because you're just designing your paperback covers and not measuring according to the Amazon standard. So now what I'm going to show you in this video is what you can do using the Amazon standard. First things first, you come to this page. I will be leaving the link in the description. Just click on it and you'll reach here. Now when you reach this page, this is the first thing you will see. After this, you come here where they say enter your book information. So you enter your book information. Under the binding type, when you click, you will choose from hardcover or paperback. So we want to do paperback, so you click on paperback. Then under the interior type, you click on this, and you can see we have black and white, premium color, and standard color. So we choose black and white. Always use black and white. For paper type, you click here and you choose cream paper and white paper. So we're going to be choosing white paper. Then page turn direction, you click here and you choose from left to right. If your book is in English, you choose left to right. If your book is in other languages, for example Arabic, then you choose right to left. So we're going with left to right. Then measurement units, you click on select, you click on this and you'll be seeing inches and millimeters. For us, we are doing our books in inches, so you click on inches. And then interior trim size, you click on this and you'll be seeing these, or all these are acceptable trim size, which are acceptable by Amazon. These ones are acceptable by Amazon. So the one we always use is 5.5 by 8.5 inches. It's the one we mostly use. And if you're using 6x9, you select 6x9. And then one of the most common ones used is 8.5 by 11 inches. That's one of the common ones. And then there's 6x9 and 5.5 by 8.5 is the one we always use. So you click on this. Now, after that, you go ahead and do your page count. You go and count the pages of your book. You have to know how many pages your book has. Let's say your book has 55 pages. So you come here and type 55. If it has 60, you type 60. If it has 100, you type 100. If it has 10 pages, you type 10 pages. So let's do 55 pages for this tutorial. So I'll click 55. And you can see that now I have 55. Now you can see this yellow thing is now yellow. So now I can click on calculate dimension. And it will calculate for me and give me what I'm looking for. So let's click on calculate and see what it will bring. Now, as you can see, it has brought for me everything I need to know about making this book cover, including a template which can guide me on how to make this book cover. So first things first, let's look at this side of the thing. And you can see that first of all, it says the full cover. So this is the size of the full cover. It will be 11.374 by 8.75. this is the full cover. And the front cover alone will be in 5.5 by 8.5. Then the safe area is 5.375. You can see that. And then you continue and you can see that everything is accounted for. From here, all you have to do is go down here. So all I have to do is come here and click on download template from down here. Click on download template and it will download the template. And then we can pick it and use it. So it has brought it here. So I click on start download. And you can see that it will download it for me. And now we can pick it and go and use it inside Canva or any other software we want to use it in. So I'll just click here, open folder, click on this, and you can see that it will open the folder and find where it is. I'll copy it and I put it where I can find it. After that, I double click and I extract the file, the template here. I'll just extract it here so that we can see what is inside it. So I've extracted it. Now if I double click on it, you see that one, it has come in PNG and PDF form. So this is my template. Now when I'm designing my book on Canva, this is the template that I'm going to use. Yes, so it is even explaining itself. It says black solid line equals to trim size. You see this black solid line, this is the trim size. When the machine of Amazon is cutting the book, they'll cut it at this line when they're cutting to send to the customer. So you make sure nothing is on this line. Then we are saying blue dashed line equals to spine fold. Now this blue lines are the spine folds. Spine folds means when you're folding the book, this is where it will fold from. When you're folding a book, this is where it will fold from. You know a book, most of you have held a book before. So when you're folding the book, it will fold from there. And then white area equals to live area. Position logos, text, and essential images in this area. So this white area, all this white area is where you're going to put your content, the content of your book cover. So this is where you're going to put the content of your book cover, such as logos, text, and any essential image should be in this area, should not pass this white area. Then red area equals to out of live stroke bleed. So the red area is the bleed. This red area is the bleed. Every part which is red is the bleed. The bleed means the part which, if your image is to go extra, then it should go up to the bleed. Yes, up to this area. Then they're saying remove this template layer from final artwork. So you have to remove it from your final artwork. It should not be on your final artwork. And they have given you the size here, and everything is set. Everything is set. So all you have to do is take this into Canva and start designing our book cover. So I am here inside Canva and I want to start the process of creating my book. So all I have to do is come and create, click on create a design. I want to create a book cover. I click on create a design. Now from here, I'll go to custom size, which is down here. I click on custom size, then I input my size here. But to get the size, I first come here and read the size on this paper. And as you can see, this thing says the overall dimension should be 11.374 by 8.750. But I have to first make sure this is in pixel, in inches. So I'll change this to inches first, and then I can input my numbers. So after changing it to inches, then I can put 11.374 by 8.750. So 8.750, that's the overall dimension. Then I come here and click on create a new design. Click on create a new design, and you can see that it will create. So as you can see, this is the design and it has been created. Now the next thing we have to do is go ahead and create our book cover. But before we do that, we have to go and create the book cover. Not from here, we have to get our already made book cover, or we can create a new book cover. So let me show you the designs that I've made before using this. So this is the book cover that we're going to use. We're going to use this book cover, and now you can see that this is the front page. This is one of the templates, and I'll be leaving the link to this template in the description. You can access it for free, plus 10 plus more templates which are like this one exactly, and they are free for you to access. Now, I'll be using this particular template for this tutorial so that you can see what will happen. So from here, you can see that this template is complete. This is the front page, the front part, and this is the back part. Yes, so this is the back part. Now, all I have to do is download these ones in JPG format. So I'll come here to share, click on share, come to download, and then I'll select, make sure I'm on JPG, select this. Then I want two pages, and then click on download, and it will download for me this template the way I want it to be downloaded. So the template has been downloaded. I can click on open and go to where it is. I pick it from here. I copy it, and then I move it to my, I move it to this folder, and I paste it here. After that, I can click here and click on extract to extract it inside this folder. So you can see that it's 1 and 2, and then next I can import all these to my assets inside Canva. So I'll come inside Canva to uploads here, click on uploads. Yes, after clicking on uploads, click on this upload files. After this, go ahead and locate the folder, and I remember I named it Amazon, so it is here. So I'll first bring them one by one because the other one is refusing. So I'll first bring the back cover. Now I'll bring these two, one, I'll highlight all these two, and I bring them in to Canva. So you can see that now that they are uploading. Now when they upload, now you can come to this side. Now from here, I'll go to uploads. They should be here in uploads by now, as you can see. Now first things first, I have to first make sure this one, I bring this one and I extend it up to this extreme corner, and I put it there, then I extend it up to here and make sure it's in the middle. Yes, and then I make sure it's in the middle, and then I drop this one also. I bring it this side and I make sure it is in the middle, comes up to the middle. Yes, now it's leaving the spine. Now I can change the color of the spine to match the color of this back cover. So I'll just click here and I make sure it is cream like this back cover. So you can see that it's now a complete book. Now the purpose, the reason why I brought this one in is to use it to measure this. So you can see this space. You may be wondering what this space is for, and this space is for the barcode. See this yellow thing? So if I click here, you can see that this thing is going to fall here. After falling here, I can extend it to match the size of this exact template. So I extend it to match the size of this exact template, and then I can, all I have to do is make sure I reduce the transparency to see if everything is falling in line. So As you can see, when you see here, you're going to see that things are in line. Now, when you check this, you're going to see that things are in line. And anything which is excess is now. You see, as you can see, this image has passed, has gone past the cover. And we said any part which is red is called the bleed. So this is the bleed. Yes, so this is the bleed because the image has gone past that. But the rest of the image, they are fine. They are on the right, correct path. They have not gone beyond any trim size. So that is the. This means that this book cover is now perfect and we can now upload it. Now, all you have to do is first bring back the thing, bring back this and remove it from the book cover. Click on delete and remove it. After that, you download this, so you click on download and you download it as PDF standard. So you can download it as PDF standard or PDF print. So I'll download as PDF standard and then I click on this flatten and then I click on download PDF. So as you can see, it is downloading and I'll wait for it. And that is how you design a book cover for Amazon KDP paperback. So with that said, this is the end of the video. If you like this kind of content, make sure you hit that subscribe button. That don't miss what I'm going to show you in the next video.